here I have some flour, and to that I'm going to add in some sugar just for taste. And then here's some salt. Then you want to mix this first, and you want to use your hand for this recipe just because we're going to add the liquid slowly, and you want to know if it's too much liquid or is it already enough. You don't want your dough to be too wet. I'm going to add in my oil, and I'm going to mix this egg first. Then we're going to add it too. Now you want to start mixing it with your hand. You just go from the center out like this. Once you have something like this, you want to slowly add in your milk. So you want to have something like this. It's very soft but not sticky. That's when you know that you're putting the right amount of liquid. So now we're going to start and knead this. So I'm gonna put a little bit of flour there, then I'm putting my dough. Now you want to start and knead your dough, and if it's a little bit sticky, just add some more flour, and you want to knead it until it is very smooth. Once you have something like this, it is already smooth. Now we're going to divide the dough into 8. Then you want to make a ball, and you just want to tuck all of this there. Just pull it like this. Just pinch it. That's how you make a perfect ball. Then you want to get your big bowl that you use to mix the dough, and get some oil, and you want to just pour it there a little bit, not a little bit but a lot. Then you want to get one of your dough, give it a massage with the oil. Give a generous amount of oil on this because the oil will help you a lot later. So just give it a nice massage. And another trick, instead of making it into a round shape, you want to make it into a disc, so just press it a little bit like that, and give some more oil. No, be generous with this oil, and put it there. And don't worry if they got stuck in one another like this, it won't stick anyway. Then you want to get your remaining oil, just pour it in. Give it another massage. Tip it also to make sure that the bottom part is covered with oil. If not, they're going to stick, which is a bad thing. So slippery. Then you want to let it sit on the counter. You don't have to cover this because it has already been covered with oil. You want to let it sit for at least 2 hours. The longer, the better. The longer you keep them resting, the stretchier they'll be. And the reason why we are resting them is because we want it to be very stretchy, and right now the dough is kind of stressed from all the kneading, so it's going to be very hard to stretch. It is stretchable dough, but it's a little bit hard. You can wait for at least 2 hours or overnight. So just let it sit there, and we just gonna wait. Dough have been sitting for about 2 hours now. Now we are going to start and shape our dough. And what you want to do first is put some oil on your table, like a lot of oil, like this. I just put a lot of it. Then you want to get one of your dough, and it is like super stretchy now. It's so easy to stretch, and you want to stretch it a bit with your hand. Just spread it like this. Don't worry if you have holes, it doesn't matter actually. Now you just want to pull it, see how stretchy it is, and look at that, it's a hole. Don't worry about that. Okay, that's a big hole, but yeah, don't worry about that, okay? So you will have something like this, and put some more oil there, dab it in. One of my tricks is you put the oil in your hand and just dab it everywhere. Roll it until it is big enough and thin. Because if it's too thick, it's not going to cook very well and it's not going to taste very good. It's not going to be flaky and yeah, all the goodness. Okay, so now we're going to cook the roti, and here I'm using a non-stick pan, so I'm not using any oil at all. But if you guys don't have a non-stick pan, then you should put a little bit oil on your pan. And you want to cook it in a low-medium heat so that the roti will cook thoroughly. So you want to have something like this. It is kind of crisp. It's crispy, golden brown, and also it kind of puff up a little bit. Here I'm putting it closer to you, see it kind of puff up a little bit. And then you want to flip it again. Look at that. Ooh, wow, look at that. It's kind of puff up even more. Now I'm going to show you guys the most important step in making roti pratha or roti canai. So just flop it there. Now, you want to smash it. Actually, that is why the shape doesn't really matters, but yeah, it is so good. So you wanna do this, just really mash it. And there you have it. And you are ready to enjoy it. It smells so good. Okay. Ooh. So this is the pratha that I just smashed, and I just want to show you guys one of the signs that your pratha is, one of the signs that you're making it right is when you have this. It's like layers of layer. Look at that. Look at that. That is the sign that you're making your pratha the right way, and it should be flaky but still kind of chewy on the inside. So if you guys like this video and this recipe, please give it a thumbs up. If you guys want the full recipe, you guys can go check it out on Instagram. Link is on the description box below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel as well. So thank you so much for watching, guys. See you guys on the next video. Bye bye.